Hello everyone, in this video we have three circles and O1 is the center of the smallest circle and O2 is the center of the middle circle and then O3 is the center of the biggest circle. And then these red points, these are tangent points and X is asked. Okay. First of all, notice that radius 1 is given 1 unit, that means here these are 1 unit, right? And then radius 2 is given 4 units, so these two parts must be equal 4 units. Okay. And then if you connect these two points, here must be equal 90 degrees, right? Because of tangent. Likewise, if we connect these two points, this angle must be equal 90 degrees. Okay. And then if you draw a parallel line like this, so these are must be equal 90 degrees. We know that here is radius, so this side is equal 1, and notice that we get a rectangle, right? That means if it is 1 unit, this side must be equal 1 unit. And then we know that radius of the middle circle equals 4 units, so 3 units left here. Right? Okay. Let's call this side y unit, and for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of y, right? So 3 squared plus y squared equals this side 1 plus 4 whole squared. Therefore, 9 plus y squared equals 25. So y squared equals 16, therefore y equals 4 units. That means here, equal 4 units, you know that these two sides must be equal because of rectangle, so here equal 4 units. And then, notice that these three parts must be equal. So the three parts must be equal to units, right? Why? Because, let's remind you, let me connect here. If we have a circle and let's draw two tangent line, according to two tangent theorem, these two parts must be equal, right? And then let's draw one more circle, which is tangent these two points. According to two tangent theorem, these two parts must be equal, right? That means these three parts must be equal to each other. Okay. And then let's go to the question. Notice that these three parts must be equal to each other. Okay. Therefore, notice that if here is x plus 2, that means this part must be equal x plus 2, right? Why? Because, let's remind you again, let's connect here. Notice that here, let's call here center of the biggest circle, and let's draw a chord which is same. If you notice that this red point is a tangent point, right? So here must be equal 90 degrees, right? Okay, and then if it is 90 degrees, that means this chord must be divided into two equal parts. Because you know that if you draw a perpendicular from the center, the chord must be divided into two equal parts. Okay. And then, if you apply power of a point formula for this blue point, notice that 2 times this part equal 8, right, equal x plus 2 times x plus 2, right? Let's remind you, if you have a circle like this, and let's draw two chords which is intersected, and let's call these parts A, B, C, and D. According to power of a point formula, A times B must be equal C times D, right? Okay. Therefore, 16 equal x plus 2 whole squared, right? Let's square root both of the equation. These are again. So 4 equal x plus 2. That means x equal 2 units. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel.